We're gonna cross our fingers here because if you've seen previous videos, fairly recent videos, you know that my bike was sitting for a little bit and it wouldn't start. So this is the same day, even though you're watching this video on a different day, that we had to jump start the bike. Started up just fine after we jump started. Been riding around for about 45 minutes or so. We're going to stop here at the gas station because now the bike needs gas. And we're gonna see if the bike starts up after I get gas. I'm thinking that we'll be okay, but this might turn into a whole different video here if we've gotta wait for that one gal to hop on over here and jumpstart me up. Well, leave it in the comments. Are you one of those people who stops in the first stall? Or are you one of those people who is courteous and pulls forward to the next stall so that the person coming up doesn't have to go around you? Leave that in the comments. I've got my fingers crossed. Let's cross our fingers. Knock on wood. Here we go. Yeah. We're all charged back up, baby. So I've learned the hard way certain aspects of owning a motorcycle, and you know, I'm sure those of you who have to park their bike for the winter know about starting that bike up for the first time. I'm sure those of you who leave your bike parked for the entire winter, I'm sure you probably pull the battery cables off. You know, I don't have that aspect of owning a bike in a place that snows all winter and you can't really ride. So, you know, leave it in the comments. What do you do besides, I don't know if you disconnect your battery, but I'm guessing that's probably one of those things that people do who own a bike and like Ray Ray, I know that you probably do this. Storing the bike for the winter. But other than disconnecting the battery, I'm sure there are other things that you've got to do. So I am curious because I do not live in one of those climates where I can't ride for that long. But there have been times, you know, one of the other times that I can think of specifically, thank you for not doing that. One of the other times specifically was when I had three different things. I had a show going, you know, maybe my kids had a bunch of different activities, so I just could not get on the bike. I want to say it was like 2.5 months. And actually, at the end of that, I actually ended up selling my bike because it just felt like there was never going to be a time where I wasn't going to be busy. So I just sold my bike. And I love the crap out of that bike. That's probably because that was unknown territory. I sold that bike and I didn't know whether or not I was gonna get another bike. So that was definitely one of those times that it was kind of like, I thought maybe that I wouldn't ride anymore. And if it wasn't the fact that I wasn't going to ride anymore, it was that I didn't know the next time I would ride or the next time I would have a motorcycle. So it turns out after I did that, after I thought I had all this time, that I didn't have enough time on my hands to have a motorcycle anymore, it didn't even last a year. I bought my Fat Bob later that year and I started my channel. It's funny how things work out in life where you kind of get into this unknown area. I think what happened at that time was that I was teaching a theater class, I was teaching a dance class, I was in a theater production. And then I had my job. So I essentially had like three jobs and I was not riding like at all. And I loved my bike and I loved to ride my bike. I just never had the time to get out. And so it sat for at least 2 months it sat. And I just told my wife, you know, I hate that my bike is sitting here not getting ridden. And I would rather somebody have it and then have that money, you know, have that, because I had already paid the bike off, but to have that money, to do something, you know, pay off bills or whatever it might have been that we did at the time. And so I did it. And, you know, that's probably one of those times in my life that had I actually maybe thought about the fact that I wasn't going to teach the classes forever, and I was gonna just miss the freaking crap out of writing. You know, it wasn't too long after that that I started watching moto vlogs because I missed it so bad. And at that same time, I thought, well, I love these moto vlogs. You know, this feels like something I could do. And so getting into moto vlogging gave me this like creative outlet that I was using theater and my dance classes and stuff to fulfill my life. So moto vlogging has just been one of those, we'll call it a blessing. I feel really lucky to be a moto vlogger. And I would just, I guess, to turn this back on you guys, is there's gonna come times in your life, and maybe you've gone through one or two of these times in your life, where you kind of can't see, or you don't know what's coming up in the future. You don't know, even though you might have vague or very specific plans, you don't know what's gonna happen, because, you know, maybe your job is in limbo, or maybe you're looking for a new job, and things are just very uncertain. And I would just say to those of you who are in that position in your life, is take things one step at a time and trust the decisions that you make. They might, in very near hindsight, feel like bad choices or bad decisions. But in the long run, you know, we talk, you know, there's that song, the broken road to find your way to where you are. You know, we all lead these lives that have broken roads. There's never what I would call a straight path to reach your goals or to reach or to be where you want to be. It always seems like, whether or not you have a very specific plan, you know, life is unpredictable. And you might have a very specific plan, but then, you know, your car breaks down. You got to pay for your car. So financially, you're strapped for cash. You know, you might have all the money in the world, and you lose your job. I don't know. There's as much as you can plan your life out and make plans of the things that you want to do in your life, you just never know. So my message for you today, and this is kind of a sound like a cheesy message, but hey, I'm not above that here. Well, but my message for you guys here today is to take things one step at a time. You know, when you make what you might think is a mistake, it's taking you down a road. Enjoy the ride. And I know, and we, you know, we can bring this right back to riding bikes. It's just enjoy the ride. I like to think of myself as a duck sometimes, because I always let negativity and I let bad news roll off my back like water on a duck's back. Yeah, I'm sure you've all heard that metaphor. But, you know, I also am a very anxious person. I suffer from anxiety. And, oh, dude, that's an awesome rainbow. Can you see that in the video? Oh, my gosh. That's spectacular. We got to find a place to pull over and take a picture with this. Oh, man. That is an amazing rainbow on a very blue sky. And now that I say that, there's water on my screen. And now the batteries die. At least this camera's still rolling. All right, we're going to find a place to take a picture with this rainbow. Maybe right here. Yes, I think this is gonna work. Okay. Oh, this is awesome. Okay. Talk about the windy road, right? Enjoying the ride. This is like one of those times where you just gotta take what happens and roll with it. All right. That camera's turning off. This camera's still rolling. Guys, we're gonna leave this video right here. My bike's getting rained on. I don't care, because we've got a rainbow over here and it's just a great day. We're out on the bike. Guys, if you like this video, make sure you hit that thumbs up down there, which is the like button. And if you haven't already, please smash that subscribe button. Guys, if you're out there riding, be safe. And if you're not riding, get riding. I'm that one guy, and I am out.